Hey everyone, welcome, welcome. My name's Charlie, and today I'm going to be playing APICO, which is the loveliest and most relaxing beekeeping game ever. This is a sponsored video, but I am genuinely in love with this game. Before accepting the sponsorship, I decided to try out the demo, and then I continued trying out the demo for literally 2 days straight, so I'm incredibly hyped to start playing the full version, and I think we should just dive right into it. Okay, my name is Charlie, and I am setting sail. Let's go. Oh, some airmail. Okay, dear Charlie, it was so lovely to get your letter last week. I think it's wonderful that you're taking an interest in beekeeping again. Both me and Gramps had always hoped you'd want to carry on the keeper family tradition. So we've got a Stardew-esque leave the city and go into the countryside to live out your dreams and be happy with the bees. I've posted you a ticket for the next boat that comes in. Skipper will be overjoyed to see you again after all these years. Have a safe journey. Love, Nana. We made it, Charlie, and just as you were getting your sea legs, ho-ho! Here we are, Port APICO, and what a lovely day it is. I agree, Skipper. Anyway, you best go see the old girl. She's just at the end of the pier and down to the left. She's been a-buzzin' over since you let her. Oh, okay, goodbye, Skipper. Thank you so much for all your help. Okay. It's my Nana!
Oh, Charlie, it's so wonderful to see you. Have you had breakfast? Shall I put the kettle on?
Oh, are you making me tea? I love tea, but not as much as I love bees, Nana. Okay, so we're left to our own devices here. I'm gonna check my guide. I don't meet the requirements. Okay, that's very tragic.
Oh, I got a bee?
I got a free bee. That is adorable. Punch some trees, pick some flowers, scare some birds, go hog wild. I will do that. So our first quest is to gather some resources with our axe that we just acquired. So I'm gonna do that. Oh, it's a blue beehive. Hello? Okay. I want this. How do I take this? Okay, I need a hammer for that. I will be right back. So I believe we need this saw bench. Craftaroo. And then I'm going to put the saw bench right there. And with that saw bench, I'm going to create some sticks because I need that to make my hammer. I literally love the mechanics in this game so much. And the menus are so good. They're so like intuitive and you can move them around. It is, Alrighty, so now I have myself a hammer. And is there anything else I need? I probably need a pickaxe or something, but I'll wait on that. I'll wait. Actually, no, I won't. Now I can have a pickaxe. Okay. I'm ready to go collect my beehive. My first beehive. Okay, let's look around this little town. It is so cute and I want this. And I now have it. Okay. What is this? There's a little notice board. Hold shift. Shift. Okay, apparently I'm taking that now. Sounds good. What's this? Oh, okay, I'm taking it. Well, you know, none of these people want to save the bees as much as I do, apparently, because they haven't been saved yet, so I deserve all of this stuff. This is all mine, and I'm going to save the bees single-handedly. I do not need the help of these townspeople. Sorry, Grandma. Let's see. Let's find a good place of solitude to set ourselves up. This seems like a nice little spot. Let's just clear out some trees. This looks like a good little area. I'm actually very excited. This is an amazing start. Actually, hold on. I need house materials. All right, you don't need this anymore. I swear, I said I was coming and I was gonna help and you know, everything, blah, 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 blah. But this, I need these materials in order to do so. I'm very sorry, Granny. Okay, now we're cooking. Now we're really cooking. I can't place walls on top of things. Okay, good to know. And okay, I'm gonna go get the rest of Grandma's house. I'll be back. A very cool feature about this game is that it's actually cross-play multiplayer, so you can have up to 4 players in the same world. Unfortunately, I don't think any of my friends have the passion to save the bees and destroy their grandmother's houses quite like I do, but I could see that being a really good time. Okay, I've got my building materials that I sourced from making them myself and not from stealing, and I'm gonna go make my house in the woods. I'm actually— oh my god, there's another house? I'ma loot that later. Okay, now I have my materials. It is time to start building our bee empire. This is big. Oh, that looks beautiful. Mm-hmm. That's really nice. Then I'm gonna put the town notice board and this statue that we stole right in front of the house. I'm sure they'll never figure out who did it. So I don't know how many people know this about me, but I'm actually also a biologist, so saving the bees is something very important to me and something that's important for all of us. Like, bees pollinate our food, bees keep ecosystems functioning, they increase biodiversity. Bees are very, very important. And one of the things I think is so, so cool about this game is that a portion of the profits from game sales actually go toward funding bee conservation projects and beekeeping in real life. So by playing this game and just chilling out and relaxing, you're also making an impact as well. Okay, so we've got a little bit of a pathway going. Our house is in the works. It's looking a little rough, I won't lie. But I think that we're ready to start collecting some bees. Okay, so this is our first beehive. I'm going to just place it right here. That looks real good. And now what we can do is we can breed two bees in order to make a queen. And then I'm also going to just put some other bees in the hive just to help out. So we got a forest queen. But my priority right now is going to be to go around and collect some more hives and try to get some new types of bees. I'm grabbing this one. And I'm grabbing this one. Yoink. There's also a little house up here. I think it's abandoned, so stealing from it actually isn't that shameful. Oops, I stole everything. Okay, well, we can make like a little pattern. We'll have like green, yellow, green on this top row. Oh, that's nice. We'll start a little row of the blue hives down here. And inside of that, we will put our verge bees. Okay, we also stole this basic apiary from that guy in town. I have no idea who that was. Maybe the mayor or something, but we stole this. And I think that we can actually put the bees in here too, but we're gonna need some of these little doodle daddles. What are those called? I don't know that much about bees, but I would really like to know more, and I think that playing this game is a pretty good way to find out. Okay, so we need some wooden frames. So I'm gonna craft two of those and put some bees in here. And I'm pretty sure that the apiary is where all of the bee breeding actually happens. Like, I don't know if you can breed in these ones so much, but let me just put in, oh lord. I'll put in a forest bee and a common bee. We'll see what comes of that. We'll see what happens. A forest common queen! Beautiful. And I'll just put some bees in there to help out. Wait, the bees love the flowers! Oh, did you see that? Okay. Wait. Important matters to attend to. We need to put some flowers out for our bees. Oh, you like that flower? How about this one? Oh, how about more? Oh, they all love them! Oh, there's so many! They're so cute! They love them so much! I love you so much, bees. Thank you so much for all you do. Look, they're pollinating! Wait, they're making more! Oh my god, I love this game so much. They're so cute! I'm gonna get some of this stone too, because I want to upgrade my tools. They're kind of really terrible right now. It would be nice to get these big rocks and stuff. That would do wonders for the landscaping. And think of all the flowers we could have. Oh my gosh, I'm so excited. I'm pretty sure that some of the townspeople have like quests and stuff to do. I immediately ran away from them to be in solitude with the bees. So I should probably actually go check what they wanted from me. Okay, oh my god. Grandma looks so sad. Hello? How do I talk to you? Did I just kill my grandma? Oh my god. Oh my god. Oh my god. What do I do? What? Oh my god. I need to run. I cannot believe that just happened. What am I supposed to do? And why is she in my pocket now? Oh my god, I'm so scared. I'm just gonna keep working on my house, alright? Don't you worry about it, grandma. Oh my gosh, the bees are pollinating so much. I love it. Let's see what quests we're supposed to be doing. Carpentry 101. Okay, so we used our saw bench a couple times, actually. Now we need to make basic tools. We can make this little wooden spade. And, oh, we'll actually get a bunch of stone, which is good, because it means we can make better tools. So let's actually do that real fast. Do I have any sticks in here? Any sticks? No sticks, okay. And let's see, craft one wooden shovel. And we've done it. Claim our reward. In terms of bee quests, let's see. So we already have the common bee, the forest bee, and the verge bee, so we can go ahead and claim that. Now, we have to pick up some flowers. So we should get 5 of the yellow, the blue, and the pink. in order for our bees to be happy. And really, all that matters in this life is that the bees are happy. Okay, so this crate is gonna be our bee. Oh my god, I forgot we killed our grandma. Okay, ignoring. Oh, it's so hard to ignore. What do I do about this lady that I literally murdered? Can I, like, hold? Can I? Oh, grandma! You're okay! Grandma, you can go sit in the garden. I'm sure you'd love it out here. She looks so happy. The bees are all sleeping, I think, so I'm gonna go collect some stone and collect some- What is this? A bee! New discovery! We found a new bee! The rocky bee. Holy crap, there's so many bees. Oh god, I'm gonna get so obsessed with this game. Wait, we got a rocky bee, and the conservation status is lost? Okay, so that's another really cool thing about this game, is that some of the bees have actually already kind of gone, like, locally extinct. So, we actually get to rehabilitate those bees by breeding them in our apiaries, and then re-releasing them into the environment so that they're no longer not conserved. Okay. Oh, our apiary is done. And also, our wooden frames are full. Oh my goodness. Okay. So I'm gonna make a stone queen in the apiary, and then hopefully we can breed some more bees, some more of these rock bees, to release into the wild. Okay, this is looking nice. I also haven't slept in 2-3 whole days, so that's probably not good, but hey, bees are more important than sleep. Let's talk with these people. What has this guy got to say? Barnaby. Oh, so this guy sells bees. Ah. And who is this? Dr. Benjamin BHD. Oh, it's you again? What do you want now? I haven't even ever talked to you before. Why are you so rude? Oh, wait. Is it because I stole all your stuff? Yeah, that makes sense. Actually, I'm just gonna go ahead and finish up right here before I head out today. If you want to upgrade your machines, you should start by collecting lily pads to make waterproofing. That is interesting. And you sell wood stuff. Okay, cool. Why is there a dot 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 on my apiary? It's because it's full, isn't it? Yeah. Oh, they're sleeping. Oh, so sorry. Okay, so I grabbed the two, like, wooden frames, and I'm pretty sure that now I need to use the thing that I stole from the doctor, the uncapping bench. So there's the uncapping bench, and this is the extractor, which I made entirely on my own. So I'm gonna put these in here, and then do this to uncap them. Now I have the uncapped wooden frames and some propolis. Okay, so now I have my uncapped wooden frames, and I will now extract them using this fun machine. Ooh. Yahoo! Yay! Okay, so I'm gonna grab these wooden frames back and all the seeds, and I'll toss these frames back into the apiary. These bees are sleeping too. Why are the rock bee queens all sleeping? I don't understand. Hello? Did I do something wrong? Maybe I should use the microscope to learn more about the rock bee, because I don't know anything and I'm confused. We'll just set down our microscope here and look right here. It says productivity is slow/normal, so maybe that's why. Oh, they're nocturnal! That makes sense. So that's why they're not doing anything, is because they're legitimately asleep, because they're nocturnal. Okay, I'm dumb. I should have checked that first. Okay, so I only have enough honeycomb to make a single apiary, but you know, that is a humble beginning, and I'm happy with it. Well, I was actually gonna go collect some honeycomb, so that is very convenient. And then there's a button here that, just quickly breeds the two of the bees on this side. I don't really care that much about, like, what the queens are like in these hives, because I'm pretty much just using them to produce honeycomb. That's probably not the way to go about it, but that's the way that I'm going about it. And we're gonna just plant some flowers literally everywhere, because I want my bees to be happy. Honeycomb, honeycomb, ooh, honey, 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 honeycomb. Ba-dum, bum, bum, honeycomb, honeycomb, honey, honeycomb. So for the next quest, it was just to make the apiary and get the wooden frame, and we already did that. So the next thing that we need to do is craft a bee box, which is gonna be used... Oh, it's used to keep an unlimited amount of a single bee species. That's actually so useful because I'm running out of room very swiftly. Okay, what do I need to make the bee box? Because I desperately need that right now. One large crate, one basic apiary, and then a honeycomb. Okay. And now I can make my bee box. Beautiful. I'm actually going to do it in rows here just to make it easier for myself. So I'm going to make this bee box just filled with the common bees. Okay, cool. And then I'm going to have to make another bee box for like the forest bees and the, what are these? The verge bees. Oh, this game is so cool. I love it so much. Now you have an apiary, you'll be able to start crossbreeding. To get started, crossbreed a common and forest bee together into a common forest queen. See if you can get a verdant species as one of the offspring. Okay, we can do that. Hopefully that does something. I don't know when I would know, but I'm sure that I'll know when I know, you know? Oh, wait, the rock bees are doing things. Oh my gosh, we got more! Now we have 3 more bee boxes. So I'll put the verge bees into this bee box. And this one will be for my forest bees. And now I just need one for my rock bees. It has been 4 days and I still have not slept, but again, I'm not going to sleep because I want to collect some flowers and surround my entire house with flowers. I want my bees to be happy and I really genuinely think that that's going to make them the happiest. Oh my gosh, what's happening? It's raining! Water is falling from the sky! Somebody help! Oh my gosh, we got so many. We have like 40 of every kind of flower. They better love it. That's looking great. That really is my vision. Yay! Okay, so I now have 3 more apiaries. This is big news. I'm gonna start putting stuff on the right side over here. So I'll put one here. And I'll put one there. Alright. Oh, it stopped raining! All my bees are happy again! Oh my god, there's a lot of them. Oh wow. Looks like these guys are done. What is this? Oh my gosh, we got the verdant bee! Oh my gosh, that is so exciting. Learn more. Tell me more. Oh, this conservation status is lost too. We have to rehabilitate these ones. Really hope that I didn't mess that up. Verdant queen. Okay, perfect. Oh, this is going so well. This is going so well. I'm actually so excited. And we got a reward. And our reward is 2 frames, which is very convenient because we actually needed that. So what is this? Fizzy Wizzy. Now we've got honey, we can start putting it to good use and make some apicola. To get started, you'll need to craft a fermenter, which takes rainwater and honey and ferments it over time. Oh, okay. These bees are done. We got another verdant bee! Oh my gosh, this is so exciting. And it's a blessed bee. I don't know what that means still, but I'm so happy about it. There. This does not leave much space, I will not lie. But I think I'm gonna put my apicola stuff in there and have like a little factory area. It has been ages and I have crafted like a bajillion sticks. So I now have 3 tree tappers to show for it. I think I'm gonna put the tappers on these trees over here just cause they're more out of the way and I'm less likely to chop them down. So we can craft rain tanks to collect and store rainwater. Later on when you're stocked with honey, we can combine the two and make apicola. So we need to make a little place to store our rainwater. Let's see what that requires. Oh, okay, so I need to get some of these lily pads in order to make waterproofing. And then once I get these, then I can make the rain tank. So let me just do that real fast. Let me steal all of these little lily pads. My goal today is I really just want to, you know, change the conservation level of one of these bee species, whether it be the verdant or the rocky bees. I just want to do some good before I head out for this episode. But while those are going, I am going to make our rain tanks and start working on the apicola stuff. Now that we have our lily pads, we can craft some of this waterproofing, and with this waterproofing, make a water tank. Yay! Okay! So rain tanks have been crafted. I'm just gonna make a bunch of them and set them out just because I assume that we're gonna be making an empire here. And you know, when I make empires, I just go all in. This is so cool. I love this game so much. I haven't slept in 5 days and all I wanna do is keep playing this game and I'm gonna be heartbroken to put it down. I really am. Where the heck is the wood? It's raining! Yes! That is so good because that means we're gonna finally get our rainwater and we can make our apricola and we can start our empire and then we can save the bees and it'll be great. Oh, those are getting pretty full actually. We may have some apricola yet. Although I do have some rock bees breeding back at home, it seems like when I destroy the big rock piles, I do get a rock bee pretty consistently. So I think if I do that, It'll make it a lot easier to increase the population and ultimately rehabilitate it to end us off for today. So in order to release the bees back into the wild and increase the population, I'm pretty sure I need a very specific thing. Yeah, the rehabilitator. That's the one. And let's see how this thing works. We can place it, I guess right here. This looks like a nice, happy spot. And so you input the bees here. I can just try inputting some of these ones I just collected. I'm just gonna put all of the rock bees that I found. I think that that is honestly best for the bees. Okay, let's check and see what the status is. They're vulnerable now! We actually did it! We increased their status! Oh my gosh, that is so gratifying. I feel like I am really making a difference for this little community. I think ultimately when you get to a certain level of experience, you can actually get a boat from our boy Skipper over here. And with that boat, you can go to different islands and different places in the archipelago that have other bee species and stuff. So there is a lot of content in this game that I have not even gotten close to touching. It, like over here on the other side of this river. What the heck is that? What is this? Discover these three species to unlock this gate? Uncommon bee vibrant... What? Altar? What the heck? I didn't know there was, like, gates to other worlds here. Huh? Okay. I made the news! Why? Species saved! Igneous's Bliss, Apis Petra restored by efforts from amateur miner Charlie! Mom, I'm on the news! The Beconomist! I have never been happier in my life. I think that's probably where we'll end off for today, but we got a lot done. We saved a whole bee species, set up a little camp here, murdered and then unmurdered our grandma, and also got a lot of flowers and bees, and they're all very happy here, and so am I, honestly. I would really strongly recommend this game to anybody who's into sort of like fantasy, nature, games like that, basically Stardew Valley kinds of games. It's so relaxing and so cute, and there's a lot of things to explore in this really unique world. Thank you guys so much for watching. I really hope you enjoyed, and if you did, feel free to leave a like or subscribe to the channel. I'd love to have you here. If you'd like to see more of this game on the channel, please let me know in the comments because I'm in love with this game. I would be so happy to play more of it, and I really want to see what's in that gate, what happens when you rehabilitate a bunch of species. I want to get a boat and go to different islands. There's so much to explore, and I have really only done a tiny fraction of it. All right, well, I'll see you guys next time. Bye!